The absence of David Rocastle from the Leeds lineup had begun to attract press comment. The injury to David Batty left an opening, ironically for the game against Rocastle's former club Arsenal. The Gunners had won six games in a row before this, and it was to be a memorable debut.
I know, it's hard to believe, but when Howard Wilkinson brought me, he explained everything to me very clearly. He never lied. He never said I'd be playing in the team straight away. He said I'd been bought as a young player who had obviously had a lot ahead of him to continue to play for Leeds, and that's what he wanted me to do, and he bought me for the future.
Years ago now, way before the Strachan era started, problem. McAllister over the ball at the free kick. Strachan eagerly on the scene as well, and he delivers. Fairclough coming in, speeds up, and the header was a good one but too high. You might just see it came off Adams. Well, this was there. McAllister, who's a fine volleyer, as you saw. He put one in at that end of the ground earlier this season at the expense of Liverpool. Tony Adams is saying that the goalkeeper is in too much pain, but can they get the substitution done before the corner is taken? No. White, Fairclough, and a goal for Leeds. So Arsenal, in those extra few seconds, leaving David Seaman on the pitch, have lost a goal, and now the goalkeeper will take his leave. How they wish they could have made the change a little earlier, because you can see he's restricted in his movement, and Chris Fairclough got the header above Lee Dixon's attempt to keep it out on the line, and it's Leeds United 1, Arsenal 0. Leeds now have the platform to progress towards a win that would mean such a great deal for them. But Arsenal aroused. Rocastle. Wallace with the cross. Chapman! Great header, great goal for Leeds! And it doesn't matter who's in goal, Leeds can find a way past them. Two goals have come in a super six-minute spell for Howard Wilkinson's men. Here's Campbell. Jensen taking great care to lift the ball through the mud. That much harder than he would have otherwise had to. On a drier day, Parler trying to put some pep into the midfield. Linkar was left down by a late tackle. Wright. It's a fine try. The essence of Ian Wright to fashion something out of very little. And it's a corner. Switching it back onto the right foot, losing Dorigo in the process. And Lukic making sure it didn't dip under the bar. Corner to Arsenal. Hoping to hit back. Six successive wins behind them. 2-0 down now. Retrieved here by Paul Merson. Chapman hasn't dealt with it decisively. Plenty of help on hand. Good turn by Parler. Hangs off the back of Gary's speed. Merson again. Wanting to get the ball across. Bowles, can he reach it? He's done that. And between them, Campbell and Adams confuse each other. Campbell, Merson, Bold, there's the way forward here. Jensen has the ball, Leeds trying to play the offside. Jensen wasn't given time, dispossessed by his opposite number. The second for Gary McAllister. It is 3-0. McAllister gets the glory of the goal, but Strachan set it all up sublimely. With little over 2 minutes to go, their superiority confirmed Embarrassment for Jensen. Great determination and skill by Strachan. And the goal for Gary McAllister, who's sometimes said here to be under a shadow of Strachan when both play. But they were in harmony then.
Patty was injured in that Coventry game. By the time the Arsenal game rolled around, the man to fill his spot in the first game he was to come in and start was David Rocastle. And it was a day when everything clicked that perhaps hadn't gelled earlier in the season. The components that were all there.
Well, for starters, we kept a clean sheet and we always looked as though we were going to keep a clean sheet until David made that mistake on the back pass. And Lukey got us out the muck there. One of the few times this season when we have made a mistake that we've got out of the muck. You know, sometimes you make mistakes and get away with them. We haven't been getting away with them, but we got away with that one. Having said that, we could have been three up at half-time. We weren't. We went out and we got three in the second half. We might have got more. So it was a very, very good performance. The sort of performances we were turning in last year and the sort of performances of which we know we're capable.
The team performance that day was nearly perfect. I mean, we could have won actually 5 or 6. And, you know, that's no disgrace to Arsenal. It's just the way Leeds played on that day. I had nothing to prove to them. Maybe if I was a flop there, maybe I might have been trying a bit harder, but I had nothing to prove to them. All I had to do was do well, because everything I've got to prove is to the Leeds fans. Yeah.
There was that awkward moment, of course, on your debut. It would have been awful to gift Arsenal a goal, and you thought for a moment you had.
Yeah, I mean, it just showed you how bad the pitch was, because I did hit the ball back fairly firmly. And as soon as I saw who it went to, Ian, and, you know, normally you'd put them away, no problem. I think the fact that he was staying with me over the weekend, I thought he felt sorry for me and he thought, well, I'm not going to score this time. Maybe I'll wait next time.